time to see friends you may not have seen in a while, but it's also a way just to kind of be out, be proud, say this is who we are, and just celebrate how far the community has come.
Party rock! Yeah!
Our first award was given to Project Hope, our HIV outreach and prevention education initiative.
We won Business of the Year that year, and we strive to always do good for you guys.
You know, it's what everyone aspires to win locally. You know, there's the Tony, the Oscar, and there's the Pride Center Award. Really, they kind of go hand in hand.
Shake that.
And our second award was the Organization of the Year. We're very, very proud of that for our 25th anniversary. And that's especially meaningful to us because the AIDS Council got our start in the basement of the Gay and Lesbian Community Center.
That is the second Business of the Year award trophy that we have. What happened to the first one, Peter?
I dropped it at the award dinners.
Coming off the day
after I received the award and maybe had a cocktail or two. And dropped it and went crashing across the floor, broke into a couple of pieces. I got applauded.
It's my fourth year to be invited to do it, which is, you know, truly an honor for me to be there, and it's a lot of fun.
Those that know us the best gave us these awards, and that's incredibly meaningful.
When people come here to visit the building, how many ask to look at the awards?
About 99%.
I wouldn't think so. Yeah.
Tell
us what your reign as Business of the Year was like. Like, what kind of events did you have to go to? Did you have to wear a crown? Or was
I wear a tiara and a tutu, but it was frowned upon because that's all I wore everywhere.
Oh, well, they have been used as bookends.
It's very important because it puts the spotlight on the good that people are doing, and hopefully that can inspire more people to step forward. You know, I think just for inspiration alone, it does a great deal.
A lot of people want to know, like, how you maintain the award, because it's such a prestigious and beautiful award.
Oh, that it is. I mean, it's the top of the line acrylic. I think it was imported from India, right? Presenting our trophy with the yearly cleaning.
So there must be a very careful, precise process.
Oh my God, it's a white glove service. White glove. You might see something like this at the museum when they're handling fine art.
Favorite memories was just last year with John Zell and Libby Post together. I mean, they're like, you know, the Regis and Kelly of Albany Gaydom. You know, I don't know which one's Regis and which one's Kelly, but that's the other thing.
You do use them for a very public, you give them public exposure.
Oh,
and
great.
That's in our new outreach and testing band.
Way better than the story dice we had last week. Thank you, Pride Center.
Well, they should be proud because it shows, you know, they're being recognized by their peers and by the community for a lot of hard work and dedication, and, you know, there's nothing better than that, for being recognized for what you do.
So where do you keep your award?
What are you talking about?
Your Pride Center award. I mean, you've hosted, this is your fourth time hosting, and you must have an award. Right.
I have a Caparezzo bobblehead doll, but I don't have an award.
Oh.
This is awkward now.
Yeah, a little bit.
Yeah. I have work to do.
There's always next year.
Yeah. Right. Next year, Nora. Next year. Yeah.
Every day I'm shuffling.